Hello and welcome to the channel. The year is correct. The problem was offered at the entrance exam to one of St. Petersburg institutes back in 1907. Then it reappears at numerous other places, and this channel is going to have it as well. For solving the problem, we are going to use the following trigonometric identities. For the sum of two sines, for the cosine of half angle, and for the sine of double angle. All the identities are well known. The proofs can be found at any good textbook. So I will omit the proofs to make the video shorter. This is all you need to pause the video, and yes, solving on your own is more exciting than watching someone else doing that. Now let's solve it together. The trick here is in correct grouping. In the left-hand side, we group first and last terms, applying the identity for the sum of two sines. So half sum of x and 3x is 2x. Half difference of x and 3x is negative x. However, since cosine is an even function, we can omit minus and write just cosine of x. The remaining term in the left-hand side is just copied. In the right-hand side, we also group the first and the last terms. This time we use the identity for cosine of half of alpha. From where we can find the expression for 1 plus cosine of alpha, in the obtained equality, we substitute 2x for alpha and find that 1 plus cosine of 2x equals 2 cosine squared of x. And again we copy the remaining term. We see that the left hand side contains common factor sine of 2x, and the right hand side contains a common factor which is cosine of x. So we factorize both sides and surprise! We've got a new common factor, 2 times cosine of x plus 1. So we move the whole right-hand side to the left, leaving 0 at right, and factorize the left-hand side. The first factor is ready to use, while the second factor needs its own factorization. We can factorize it by applying the formula for the sine of double angle to the sine of 2x. This brings up a common factor, cosine of x, and let's place it as start to get the equation looking neater. Now all the factors are as simple as we can imagine, so as usually we equate each factor to 0 and get 3 possible equations for x. Note that these equations are mutually exclusive, they never clash. Indeed, if cosine is 0, it cannot be also equal to negative half. While if sine is equal to half, the absolute value of cosine must be equal to square root of 3 over 2. Therefore, the cosine may be neither 0 nor negative half. This means that we have 3 non-clashing sets of x. For the first equation, the answer is just pi over 2 plus pi k. To solve the second equation, we need arc cosine of negative half. We know that arc cosine of positive half is pi over 3. Therefore, arc cosine of negative half is pi minus pi over 3, or 2/3 of pi. And we write the answer straight according to the textbook. Plus minus 2/3 of pi plus 2 pi k. Now to the last equation. Arc sine of a half is pi over 6. This means that the students attending the exam wrote the answer as negative 1 to the power of k times pi over 6 plus pi k. Of course, k must be an integer for all cases. However, such a notation wasn't used at that time. So let's replace it in order to be consistent. For someone who may find the last expression a bit confusing, we can split the last set into two. Pi over 6 plus 2 times pi k and 5 pi over 6 plus 2 times pi k. This is the end.